Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chain Design. Today we are going to use this teardrop shape earring to talk about how to use a simple command called band. Are you ready? Let's get started. Before we get started, I want to remind you to turn on the little bell next to the subscribe so you will get my notification whenever I publish a new video. Okay, so to starting with the teardrop is quite simple. We are going to the front view and depends on what size you like to draw. I pretty much wanted to fitting into this square and that will give me a reference for something about this big. And then we want to fitting in somewhere in the middle. So that's starting with the circle and I want to use the command is called tangent on the three curves. We want tangent on here and tangent over here and the very last one is tangent over there so I can get it exactly where that fitting into that rectangle. Then I'm gonna use this one to trim off the top portion so then we'll have this is fitting into exactly size that we want. And I'm gonna come over here to draw a curve something look like this and draw another straight line something look like this. Okay, so let's give it a try. I'm going to use the command called blend tool and we're gonna blend the curve from this point to this point and see if that is the curve that you like and then we're gonna blend from here to here. Okay, and you can adjust it if it doesn't fit what you want. We are going to delete those reference line. And so then this is the teardrop that we get. And on the top, I want it to be nice and round. So I'm going to use the blend command one more time to blend it over there. And again, you can adjust it to fit into the profile that you prefer. And let's click OK. So then we'll have this teardrop over there. We will join it first and you can turn on the control point. If you still feel like, okay, you need to edit it, you can do that too. But make sure you don't want to edit way too much like this way. So you will have a kink over there. If you do want to make them smoother, you can rebuild this into one curve and make sure you always want to have more than what original have. So let's set it up for 17 and see if this deviation is bothering you. If that is, you want to set it up for higher number until you get it completely matched there. So I'm going to starting with the stop it here at 24 and I kind of just want to tweak it with my control point and because this is organic shape so it's gonna be flowy anyway. Alright, so to make it into the solid we will need to have a cross section but first of all we need to split this into two. So I'm going to use the split command with the point and I'm gonna split right here the quadrant and right here the quadrant. So now we get this two curve over there. We also wanted to creating a profile and I'm going to use the circle tool and we're gonna use the diameter that's snapping into the quadrant here and the quadrant over there. Okay, so now we have the profile. We are going to use the sweep tool, rail 1, rail 2, and you starting with the point, coming to the cross section, and you end up with the point. And when you click OK, then this is what you get over there. You also want to turn on the record history. So if this is too fat for you, for example, we're gonna pick up the curve and just kind of smash it in a little bit so it's not as fat. So this is our teardrop. And then we want to make the teardrop is kind of bend it a little bit on the right side. There are two ways to bend the things. First, I'm going to show you. Let me make a copy for comparison. If we are going to go ahead to use the bend, and we are bending just small section from here and up and going like this. You're going to notice that my surface become really, really complicated. The second way we are going to do, since this is a single surface, turn on the control point and I'm going to select everything on the top, roughly about here. And we are going to use the bend tool as well. We're gonna bend from here to here. The same thing come over here. It will say you break the history, that's all right. But I want you to do a comparison. You can see how complicated the surface become right here and how smooth and simple the surface right there. Because at this one, we are bending the control point. We are not bending the surface. And you can see the result like this. At the rendering, it doesn't matter, but it's just the surface become more complicated in this way. Okay, so sometimes I will prefer just bending the control point because it will keep the shape simpler. So we can kind of bending this way, keep bending it until that you find that's what you need. Let's talk about how to make this shape into a hollow form to reduce the weight on your metal for metal casting. First things that we can do is we can cutting the back open. So have this one trim it. So the back is flat. And then once it's flat, we can go ahead to use the cap command so it becomes solid. To make it hollow, we can use the shell command. And we want to remove this surface with the 1 millimeter thickness. Now you may get something like this, it's just shell result, it's not solid. And then if you look at it here, you're going to notice something over here, it is like overlapping. And this is the same thing when you have a shelf, it's similar with the offset surface, you're gonna have something like that. So what you can do is you can come over here and you can trim the bad part out. I actually will encourage you to trim more close to the opening because you, if you need to make a mold out of it, you don't have to go in that much. All right, so then we are going to trim this off. You're going to have something like this. Okay, so to close the one on the top, we can use the surface from planar curve and we're gonna pick up this one and this one. So we have the surface over there. Let's go ahead to join this one and this one together. And then for the surface over there, we cannot use the cap. The reason is the outside is flat. But inside one, since we offset inside, is not completely flat, so it's hard to do the cap. So what we got going to do is we're gonna try the blend tool. So we're gonna blend the surface and make sure the chain edge is auto chain equal yes. That we're gonna go from here and then the second segment will be here. And let's take a look on it. So then you will get this a little bit puffy edges over there. And then we just need to join them. So that is the first way to make it. The second way that we wanted to do, we can do is we can have this one and using the gumbo scale it down and make a copy out of it. And then we are going to having into some sort of location like this. And again, we do not want it to have the top over there. And you can adjust them into the position that you want it. And usually I will get rid of the top as well because you just don't want it to have it going that deep. If you want to make a mold, you will have the problem to do that. So let me cap this one. And then you can draw another straight line for where that opening you're going to have. For example, it's going to be like this. And having that to trim off this too. So once you trim it off, you're going to notice that those two are completely flat. So create a surface, either we're using the blend or we can use the loft tool. And we're going to loft from this point to this curve to that curve. And we'll get something like that. You might have that wiggly surface over there. And if this is not what you want and you also don't want to use the blend, we can have another way is we want to duplicate the edges of this one and that one. So we got two curves there. We are going to use the arc tool and we are going to snapping into this endpoint over here, this quadrant over here, and we're gonna create that little bump there. And then we can use the commands called sweep to rail. So rail one and rail two, and choosing that cross section we just made, and this will be another way to close that. Alright, I hope you enjoy the video. Please like and comment and share my video so I can reach more people. Hopefully one day I can meet 30,000 subscribers so I can open that membership function to deliver more exclusive video to you. Thank you for watching. I will see you next time.